a little bit about tempo, everybody. So how do you go about picking a tempo for a piece like this? You're not given a metronome mark. There's no number. You don't even have a style mark, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, you don't get allegro or andante or whatever. So how do you go about picking a tempo for something like this?
I guess I would march.
Uh-huh.
And I kind of thought about where I would feel a march would be.
Yep. That's a good first start. He gives you grand march my ear. He says march. Okay? So that's our first thing, right? Okay. I'll caution you all. This book is good, but there are a few things that are not 100% accurate. Does anybody know this piece? Yeah?
Well, yeah.
Okay. The title is not March. The title is Grand March. Right? So, for me, a Grand March would be just a hair slower than, like, a Sousa March.
Yeah, it's a different vibe.
They should have
told us.
Exactly. Right. Absolutely. And there are a number of those instances, and they get to be more problematic as we go along. And as you start working on more detailed things, those kinds of things get to be more of an issue. So just a hair slower.
Yeah.
And instead of, it tells you to print to conduct staccato, I think, in the directions. A staccato for me can definitely work in a march, but it's by and large not the way I conduct a march. A march veers more into marcato. So instead of boom, beep, this doesn't seem very grand march-like to me, right? You want to put a little bit more weight in the arm, and therefore more weight in the ensemble. Jim, bum, ba bum, yup, ba bum, bum, ba ba, yup, ba ba bum. So try that. A little slower, a little more grandiose. Concept in a piece of the tempo come from. So what in the piece gives you tempo?
I don't know, where the beat comes from, I guess.
Yeah.
Where the time is.
Yeah, where the time is. So in this case, where is the time? Yeah, it's mostly in the accompaniment. Mm-hmm. That's true most of the time. The tempo, your sense of pulse, more often than not, comes from the accompaniment. So when you're studying your scores, the first thing I look for is, once I go through and I look what tempo indications has the composer given me, I'll go through the whole thing, and I'll see what tempo indications do I have. And then, as I'm going through passages, I say, does the tempo come from the accompaniment? If we're doing a Mozart symphony, you've got your rhythm section in the cellos. That's their whole part, usually. That's where that tempo is coming from. There are cases where there is no accompaniment, so the tempo has to be in the melody itself. And there are cases where the melody leads the tempo. Those are more rare. Okay? So, when you study your score, figure out what the thing is that gives you the sense of pulse, and then when you get on a podium, you listen for it. Okay? So I can tell you're listening for the melody. The prep is working great. Add that extra layer now of listening for the accompaniment. Thank you. much more subtle, and it seemed much more martial. Did it to you?
Yeah.
Good. Well done. That was a good technique. Perfect. Who's next? Yeah. No. Stay more on the plane. Yes, yeah. Good. Good. Yep. Come to your basic position. Drop your shoulders. Now do it. Last little thing. Do you feel how do you feel right now?
I feel like I'm out here.
Uh-huh.
I also feel like
Yeah. Actually, what you're doing right now, that's I feel that from you. I think there's tension like in your lower back. I think.
Kind of like this and like this.
Yeah, okay. So try this. This is what works for me. Instead of your feet being like this, put your feet more parallel. Yeah. Well, let me. Not quite like that, but yeah, just, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. See if that helps. That aligns my hips a little better. in legato, because we're trying to create this appearance of resistance, it's you have to sort of guard against. How should I say this? Guard against getting that by just tensing up, which I'm extremely guilty of. Right? It's not just you tense and then move slower. It's trying to show resistance while being available to move, and that does all kinds of goofy things to your alignment if you are too tense. So just I think of again releasing out. So up and down, left and right, and then yum, dum, 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 dum. That's my
solution. I was gonna ask, is it wrong for me to like kind of like move a little bit like arm?
Nope. Yeah, it's not wrong to move, you just want to avoid like it always being the same kind of motion.
Okay.
Right? Because this is easy to sort of get into. And as a technique, this isn't a good thing to always have to do when you're gonna move out.
But it is a one.
Two things. For everybody, in this example, where does the tempo come from? Where does our sense of tempo come from? Is it the accompaniment? No, it's not. You don't have the accompaniment like Travis had in his example, right? So where does the sense of tempo come from? Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, from the melody, but specifically where in the melody? Like what gives us the sense of pulse? It's the pickups in general, right? Either yum ba ba or ba da da ba da 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 da. Right, that every time is sort of what moves everything forward. Can you just listen for that?
Yeah.
Right. So try come a little bit, like flatten out your arm a little bit, and then listen for that.
Thank you.
maybe I'm wrong. Just if you feel that, pull back a little bit.
Okay.
How did the tempo feel to you?
It felt kind of slow.
It felt slow?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you just make them go at your tempo?
Yeah.
Just make them do your tempo. Try again. Probably isn't going to be like a moving forward night music. So they were in your tempo, which was great. They were following you. You were definitely in control. I felt a little bit like your night music was like grooving too much. It's a little bit more on the back of the beat. So think just a hair slower and more the point. Think more sustained. Does that make sense?
Does? I don't know if I can do it.
Yeah. So here's the difference. Play a little bit for me. So here's the difference. So here's like in tempo, right? I understand we're 4 weeks into conducting or whatever it is. I get it. So
I mean it just felt like you were kind of just pulling them along instead of it's like pulling you there.
That's exactly right. Yeah. So what I was doing was I was showing a less aggressive descent and a slower or I would less of a rebound. Okay. So instead of it being bump, 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 or even yump, bump, bump. I'm sticking to the plane a little bit more. And by not rebounding as fast, that creates, instead of a feeling of next, 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 which you get from the rebound, it creates more of a feeling of like just pushing forward this way.
Right.
Does that accurately describe what you felt different in those two things? Yeah. It's this as opposed to this.
Right.
Both are useful. Try it. A little more sustained. Stay on the plane and pull through. can actively feel the tempo between those two different styles, 85% of your problems will go away. Yeah. Good. Well done. Who's playing the melody? Is somebody on the top part? Wait, which one here are we doing?
3-7.
Oh.
There's another one. Sorry, everybody.
Yeah, second one did seem choppier. Let me try to not do that.
Okay. That's not what I'm trying to trick you. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with me.
Yeah.
I feel like you're in one pattern, you're more accenting downbeats.
Uh-huh.
And with, like, yes, this is where your pulse is, but then in the other one, you're kind of referencing the ability accent of the pattern.
Okay.
Into, so, like, the 3-1-6, or 3-4-6-1.
Uh-huh, we're getting there.
Okay.
I just thought I was following you, like, as you were going up, like, I was watching the motion more, because it's just, like, this kind of thing keeping your tempo.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, it felt like on the second one, you were coming down on that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1.
Yeah, okay, good. I'll prep it that way. I'm going to prep this two different ways. Okay, so again, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The second one was much more together than the first one, okay? Okay, all that was to say, conducting in 12-8 and conducting in 4-4, even at the same tempo, is not the same thing, right? We've talked about it being or yum bum 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 bum. It's all been about the space in between the beats, okay? In our heads, it seems like, well, I'm showing beat, beat. The difference is, put 4 notes in there or put 3 notes in there, right? Wrong. Because we can show, just by the way we move between the beats, whether it's bum, 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 or yum, bum, 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 okay? 4 years of, 6-8 is not 2-4. Cost me $100,000 for 6-8 is not 2-4. But it's true. Okay? So it's a really, really subtle difference. All I want you to feel is instead of like 1 and 2 and feel 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. You're actually starting to get there naturally,
okay,
which usually does happen, but I want you to be aware of it now. Okay? So feel that difference in the inner pulse. Concept, everybody, gets it's less and less of an issue the faster the tempo is. The slower the tempo, boy, the more of an issue this is. Okay? What you all should do, go on YouTube and find a couple of videos of somebody conducting the second movement of Beethoven's Sixth Symphony. It's in 12-8, and you can just see it by the way I'm conducting. It's not 4-4. That wouldn't work. Okay? And see how different conductors deal with this. Bravo, everybody! Same thing on Wednesday. Thank you.